नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
स्टैंडर्ड 9th, सब्जेक्ट साइंस, चैप्टर 11, वर्क एंड एनर्जी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रेट ऑफ डूइंग द वर्क। सी, इन विच रेट वी आर डूइंग द वर्क? डू ऑल ऑफ अस वर्क एट द सेम रेट, और डू मशीन्स कंज्यूम और ट्रांसफर एनर्जी एट द सेम रेट? नो। सो एजेंट्स दैट ट्रांसफर एनर्जी डू वर्क एट द डिफरेंट रेट्स। ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल कंसिडर टू चिल्ड्रन से ए एंड बी। ओके, ए एंड बी इज द टू चिल्ड्रन, यू कंसिडर लाइक दिस। सो ए एंड एस वेल एस बी चिल्ड्रन। ओके, लेट अस से द वेट द सेम, वेट द सेम, बोथ आर सेम वेट, both start climbing the roof separately. Okay, they are climbing the roof. Okay, weight is same, climbing the roof 8 meter high. Okay, both are 8 meter high, but taken time is here A is 15 second and B takes 20 second. So now what is the work done by each? Okay, work done, both of them done the same work. Correct. What is the rate? But here the rate is different. The work done is the same. However, A has taken less time to complete the work. B has taken more time to do the same work. So, here the rate of doing the work is different. So, what is the idea now? In the similar way, see that a stronger person may do certain work in relatively less time. Weaker person may do the same work, getting more time by using the more time. For example, a more powerful vehicle would complete the journey in the shorter time. For example, aeroplane, or compare the bus. So the same work, what the bus is done, or the work the bus is doing, but aeroplane will take very short time. So means both are doing the work, but here the rate is different. In which the speed in which these vehicles change the energy. So here it depends upon the speed we are classifying the work. Okay, and here what will be that power measures the speed of the work done. So what is power? You see, power is defined as the rate of doing the work. So power is equal to work upon time, or P is equal to W upon T. Okay. The unit of power is watt, in honor of James Watt. So here the year is given in the 1736 and 1819. Okay, and 1 watt is the power of an agent. Agent means anything. 1 watt is the and the symbol is W. Symbol is watt. Symbol W A double D. This symbol is W will be there. Okay, and 1 watt is equal to 1 watt is the power of an agent which does the work at the rate of 1 joule per second. See, 1 joule per second means 1 watt is the power. So, I can say that power is 1W, then when the rate of consumption of the energy is 1 joule per second. So, 1 watt is equal to, we can say 1 joule per second, or we can write like this, 1 joule per second. In this way you are writing 1 joule per second. Got the idea now? So he expressed in the larger units, that is kilowatt. So what will be that? The watt will be kilowatt you are using, the bigger unit. So that is 1 kilowatt is equal to 1000 watts. So kilowatt 1 kW is equal to 1000 watts. Okay, 1 kilowatt. So you can write in the short form 1 kW is equal to 1000 joule per second. In this way also you can write. So the power of an agent may vary with the time. So here depends upon the time also. This means that the agent may be doing the work at the different rates at different intervals of time. So different rates, different intervals of time. Okay, kitna time mein, kitna work करेगा. दिस इज इन दिस वे दिस इज द पावर कितना वर्क, कितना टाइम में कितना वर्क हैज इट बीन डन. सो वी ऑब्टेन एवरेज पावर. सो इट कैन देयरफॉर हियर बिकॉज ऑफ द डिफरेंट टाइम्स, डिफरेंट रेट्स इन द डिफरेंट इंटरवल्स ऑफ टाइम. सो देयरफॉर द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ एवरेज पावर इज द वी ऑब्टेन the total energy consumed by dividing the total energy consumed by the total time taken, total energy and total time taken. Now we'll discuss about the commercial unit of energy. So bigger the unit joule is too small. See, commercial unit means what? See, you know that when the industrial areas and household areas or machines, they usually, you know that the energy is what all the other energy is by the joule. But here the unit will be different in the commercial unit, because in the industrial areas as well as in household areas, here electrical energy is in the terms of unit measuring. Okay, electricity is measuring by the unit. So that is why I am saying the commercial unit. Bigger unit of energy is kilowatt hour, or you can write the kWh. 1 kW is equal to 1000 watts that you have learned already. So the unit of joule is too small and hence is inconvenient to express in the large quantities of energy. So we use the bigger unit of energy, that is called as kilowatt hour or kWh. So what will be there? kWh, kilowatt hour. Okay, what is 1 kilowatt hour? 1 kilowatt hour means what? Let us say, for example, machine uses 1000 joules of energy in every second. If this machine is used continuously for 1 hour, it will consume 1 kWh energy. 1 kWh of energy. So means 1 kWh energy used in our 1 hour at the rate of 1000 joules. So 1 kWh. 1 kWh means what? 1 kWh means you are doing 1000 into 1 kWh. 1000 into 1 hour, so means 3600 seconds. So you know that answer will be what will come, 36 and 5 zeros. 4, 5 zeros. And the same thing you can write 3.6 into 10 raised to 5. Okay, sorry, 10 raised to 6. 3.6, because here you have done the standard form, 3.6 into 10 raised to 6 zeros. Okay, in this way you can write. Okay, what is the idea now? Okay, in this way, you can write 1 kWh is equal to 3.6 multiplied by 10 power 6 joule. The energy used in the households, industries and as well as commercial establishments are usually expressed in the kilowatt hour. So in which unit? Kilowatt hour. So that you can write in the short form kWh. For example, electrical energy used during the month is expressed in the terms of units. See, at home and this one, you see, electrical energy is measured in the unit wise. So here, 1 unit means 1 kilowatt hour. So 1 unit is equal to, so what you write? 1 unit is equal to 1 kWh. So, okay, remember this one. 1 unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour, in this way you can write. Okay, what are the idea, students? Now, for example, you see, in a home, suppose, so like this, how to calculate this one? At home, how to calculate? Here, one example, you see. For example, an electric bulb, 60 volt. 60 volt means the power, you know that 60 watt, okay, is used for 6 hours per day. 6 watt is used for 6 hour per day. Calculate the unit's energy consumed in one day by the bulb. So here what you have to write, you know that power. Power is equal to this formula you are doing. Power is equal to energy upon time. Okay. Power is equal to energy upon time. And here you are finding the energy. You are finding the energy. Therefore, P is equal to T. P into T. Power into time. Power how much? 60. But this is 60 watt. So this you have to convert into 60 watt in the kilowatt. In the kilowatt means how much? 0.06 watt. Kilowatt. and multiplied by the 6 hours,
multiplied by 6.
So answer will be here, what will get? 0.36.
0.36
will get. 0.36 units, or you can write
0.36 kWh. Okay, either units
or kWh. So it's dear students, again I will read the question. An electric bulb of 60 watt is used in 6 hour per day. 60 watt
and 6 hours per day.
6 hours per day. Calculate the units of energy consumed in the one day by the bulb. Okay, then what we have done here,
you know that 60 watt means power, how much?
Power is equal to energy upon time.
Here you are finding the energy, what energy is used,
how much energy consumed.
So it is like the same formula you have done like this. Energy is equal to power into time,
or power multiplied by time.
Okay, 60 watt will be there. So this you have to convert into kilowatt. So 60 upon 1000. So you can use like this, 60 upon 1000. So that's like 0.06 kilowatt multiplied by the 6. So this one, 0.36 units. 0.36 units or 0.36 kilowatt hour. Kilowatt, kWh. Okay, what is the idea?
So in a similar manner, one more question is given. This is about the rate of doing the work. So rate of doing work means what? Two girls of each weight 400 Newton climbed up the roof with a height of 8 meter. Say two girls will be there, climbed up the same thing in the two.
Here what is that? Two girls are using,
two girls at the same rope. Here 400 Newton weight is, and climbed up the height is 8 meter, both are 8 meter only. But the time taken is different. By time taken, girl A takes 20 seconds and girl B takes same thing, will be 50 seconds.
50 seconds.
For doing the same work has done the same. So what is the power is given? What will be the power of both? And you know that the power is equal to W upon work upon time. Or work upon time. Okay, 400 here you can use like this. 400 multiplied by and A upon T. 20. And here also 400 multiplied by A upon 50. So then deduct this, it is the 64 here. This will come 64 watt, and here we will see here 24, so means 160 watt. What becomes 160?
So who has done the more?
So power extended by the girl is power. Who has done the more power here? Who has done the more work? So power extended by the girl is 160 watt. And power extended by the girl is 64. So girl A has taken very less time. So that is why here the power is more. What you are saying? The power, the rate of doing this work is the more by the girl A than the girl B. So what is the question? Both have the same weight. Both are having the same weight. 8 meter is the height. So this height is 8 meter. Okay, height, the rope is climbed up 8 meter. And time taken 20 and 50. So by this only we will come to know that who has done the, or rate of the doing the work is more by the A. Okay, got the idea? So in this way, go through these calculations. And we have completed this lesson, dear students. See, what we have learned, you see that here potential energy, kinetic energy, law of conservation of energy, and rate of doing the work, and commercial unit of energy. So these are all important headings or topics we have completed. Okay? Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for joining us.